Hi, my name is Gabby, and I am here on YouTube to show you and share with you how to do 1920 style makeup for the stage. I was inspired by Pixie Wu, she's a professional makeup artist who helped me learn how to start off with the different look that 1920s makeup has. It's very different from 2011, so I wanted to share with you what I learned from her and my rendition of how to do it for the stage. So there's a lot of old-fashioned ideas that you don't really think about by just looking at pictures. So I wanted to just show you step-by-step of what I do. As usual, let's get started. So first, you just do your base that you do anything. Most of my makeup is MAC along with drugstore makeup. A lot of the women in this time were not into tanning or any kind of coloring. They were really fair-complected. So that's one thing to learn with this kind of makeup, is you can really be true to your natural coloring, because they weren't into being bronzed like we are today. So after you do full coverage of any kind of base or concealer you use, I use Studio Tech by MAC. This paint pot it's a primer for the eyes that I also use for MAC. Since I kiss and dance with sweaty people and I get sweaty myself in this production, the makeup's pretty heavy. I highly suggest getting a primer for your eyes alone, and get any kind of concealer brush that you can use for your eyes and paint along the top of your eyelid as well as the bottom of the eyelid, since you will see later that the eyeshadow and the shading underneath the eye is pretty heavy. So of course it's not necessary, but if you have two shows and you wear it pretty much all day, it's really nice not to have to touch up so much and redo your makeup. So the big idea for this style of makeup is what we do now in 2011 is we wing out our makeup and make our face look long and thin. But the women back then wanted to look plump and round. And you have to think, when you're shading your face, it has to be a spherical look, or like how a balloon is painted in a picture. They do that little white little piece on the front to make it look dimensional. So what we do is you do a highlighting color, and this is from MAC. It's everything that I use will be in the list below that you can actually look at. And so I'm using this with a fiber brush that just blends along with the makeup that you already have on. And the key to this is to think that you want to highlight the center of your face. Everything that you see that I'm going to do a lot with this makeup, everything is round and spherical. So you're going to go ahead and paint on top. I don't know if you can see that, but I'm going to blend it in later. It's kind of just like, you know, along the T-zone, doing the tops of the cheek right underneath your eyes and the chin. You can also do your nose, but I got this kind of nose. I don't want to highlight it anymore, so if you do want to highlight your nose, feel free. So you're going to blend it in and just give it a big blur. So when the light picks up your face, it accentuates the front of your face and not the outsides of your face. After that, you're going to also keep continuing the dimensional look of a sphere with a bronzer that we use every day now. So just a regular bronzer brush and bronzer. What you're going to do, though, is you're going to go underneath your cheekbones, put the lines here, and also on the temples of your face. So that also helps with the dimension of a round face. So whatever kind of face shape you have, this works with every kind of face shape, which is pretty awesome. So next we're going to do eyes. So you're going to start with your full eyelid shadowing color, and you're going to do just an evenly heavy eyeshadow from the inner to the outer crease and all on top of the lid. Don't be shy about giving it also into the crease of your eye, but as of 2011, we keep going this way. Don't go that way. You have to be very evenly round all the way around from inner to outer eye. So basically what you do is, instead of shading the outside, you're going to reverse it and start on the inside of the eye, from the inside to basically the middle, and shade graciously all on top of your eye, in the inside of your eye. and do go far, so you can feel, so that you are able to see the difference on stage. And then the round, the curve that you follow on your eyebrow bone, continue that from the crease all the way up to your eyebrow. And you're gonna feel crazy, but it's okay. Again, this style was really, really old-fashioned, and they really, really looked glamorous. If you look at any of the pictures of Clara Bow or Louise Brooks, they really, really went this far with their makeup. So as you see, you feel a little crazy, but that's what it is. And as long as you go from inner to center, you're fine. And then, you know, you'll feel a little crazy. I have a blender brush that I just, you know, brush all the way along so it spreads out a little bit and it's not as crazy as it feels. Or as it looks yet. To do the inside of my eye to accentuate even darker tones, I do a black eyeliner and the inside of my eye on top to, in the end, give my lashes a pop. And to balance that out, to even give the upper part of your eye more of a pop, you're gonna do a white eyeliner in the crease of the crease underneath the eye. So actually go to the crease inside of your eye and give a full white pencil shading. And from there, I continue with the purple theme and I do a purple pencil. And you're going to do a full heavy eye liner on the bottom of your eye. Again, like we did in the crease with the first purple shading, we're going to do a full evenly distributed eyeliner on the bottom of the eye. And do not be shy about this undertone, because their smoky eyes are different than ours. And the smoky eye is very, again, round. Okay, so after you do the under eye shading, I continue to emphasize this smoky eye tone with a matte purple eyeshadow. You can use the one that you already used and just a blender brush to really give it a smoky, solidified look. What Pixie Wu does with her eyebrows, you should check it out to really do a real 1920s eyebrow. But again, I, you know, want to keep my eyebrows like they are for 2011, and this is my cheating way of doing it. You're gonna basically fill in your eyebrows as you do for any show. Just give a full coloring. Now, to finish the look, to make it a cheat sheet version of the 1920s look, I continue the round arc of my eyebrow to the bottom, to the middle of my eye. So I finish the line, as you'll see. I continue to the feel of my eyebrow arc and just go down and round and down to the middle of my eye. So that alone makes you look more 1920s than just having a regular 21st century eyebrow. And so to finish the highlighting of my face, how I did the white here, I'm gonna finish with a white eyeshadow. And I do the eyebrows before I do this white eyeshadow to finish off whatever I didn't shade. And so I continue all the way down to the bottom of my new eyebrow and also on top. So those are the eyes. The last but not least, what we all women do in stage are fake eyelashes. The only thing I can suggest with fake eyelashes is you don't have any eyelashes that are uneven when it comes to the lash. Really get a lash that is evenly distributed all from inside to outside. All we have left is blush and lips. So again, you guessed it, round tones, right, with the blush. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna get, you know, a heavy blush. You're not gonna go all the way up to the cheekbone. You're just gonna have a circular brush on the apple of your cheek. So give yourself a smile and round out. Or even pat, like so. And I'm gonna finish out with just a full coverage of blush, I mean of a powder to finish it out. And the last thing that was very, very 1920s that you will really suck it to them with the look is the lips. It's called a Cupid's bow is what they called it. And what they did is they really just stuck to the inside of the lips here and didn't you know, completely line all the way to the end of the crease. So let me show you how. A really good tip to start off with is to base your lips first, the color that you used in the very beginning, all the way around. And with a lip liner, you're gonna do to the top of your lip. And from here, what you're gonna do is, you're gonna follow the true crease of your lip, not wing all the way out, and angle down. So it's as if you have like a pucker. You're gonna follow that shape of your lip. And like so on the bottom as well. See, as you see, it looks like I'm already puckering. And there's a lot of people, when they do 1920s, they make the face. That's where that face came from, is the Cupid's bow lip. See? That's what it looks like. And feel free to, you know, give a little smear so it naturally evens out. And one other thing to know about the 1920s is that they really didn't use red. They used more maroons and dark brown lips. But for the stage, I just like to use red because it gives a good pop. And lip stain is pretty awesome because it doesn't smear anywhere from whoever you're on stage with, or quick changes with costumes and all that stuff. And now the last thing I do is I give my eyelashes a finishing touch by curling them first and then layering with mascara to give the full smoky eye look. So that's the look, and I hope this helped. I hope this helped you learn your own, first learn from me, and then do your own version of what you want to do for whatever you're using this for. And after this, you'll see me put my wig on and get into costume and see the whole look of Edith Herbert in My One and Only. Thanks for watching.
Sweeter than a swisher. Mad cause I'm cuter than the girl that's with you. I don't gotta talk about it, baby, you can see it. But if you won't, I'll be happy to repeat it. My name is Kerry, I'm so very fly, oh my, it's a little bit scary. Boys wanna marry, looking at my dairy. Yeah, you can stare, but if you touch it, I'm a fairy. Pretty as a picture, sweeter than a swisher. Mad cause I'm cuter than the girl that's with you. I could talk about it, know that I'm pretty, and if you know it too, then baby, sing it with me. All eyes on me when I walk in. No question that this girl's a 10. Don't hate me cause I'm beautiful. Don't hate me cause I'm beautiful. I walk my talk the way I drip. It's not my fault, so please don't trip. Don't hate me cause I'm beautiful. Don't hate me cause I'm beautiful.
Looking for me, you could.